Good morning, Tuesday, week five into training now. So we've had 4 weeks to build up a good baseline of strength. We're in for legs today. And we just started with 10 minutes on the bike, just to warm up, get the blood flowing through the legs, get the knees warmed up. And the session is gonna work out like starting with the adductor, going into leg extension, then leg curl, before our two main heavy loading movements, which is the hack squat and leg press. And then after that, I think we've got the hyperextension and then a standing calf raise. So that's the session for today. I'll probably talk a bit throughout. But yeah, weight this morning, 117 kilo, which I've been holding for the past probably 4 to 5 days. We're coming off the back of doing calories from a mini cup, which are obviously lower, and now they have actually been taken lower from that. So we've been on that lower calories for probably the past, I'd say, 6-7 weeks, basically just to bring body composition into a healthier point than we were, because we're more sensitive to everything, training, nutrition, at a lower body weight and a lower body fat. So that's where we're holding at the moment. We're looking for a bit more of a weight drop down to the lowest 115 kilo. So I've got 2 more kilo to push down to, which will probably take another week or two. But yeah, 117 this morning. Did all my health markers, blood pressure, blood glucose this morning, which I do every day and track every day. We're weighing in every day as well, just to keep a good average. But yeah, just chipping away now. Week five, so everything's getting heavy, which is good. But yeah, we'll get warmed up, go into the doctor, and get into the session. That I like to do, and one thing you should, well, try not to do, is touch the pads together when you come into the contraction. It just takes all the tension off the adductors to try and stay, you know, a centimeter gap in between the pads. Just keep maximal tension on. Once those pads touch, the tension just goes away. So we don't want that. We want to keep constant tension throughout the set. When warming up as well, I don't go to the full stretch. You know, we've got numbers on the sides, 1 to 9. So I'll start on about 6, do a few reps on that, then go to 7, and then 8, which is fine for me. A good stretch. So yeah, we've got a top set on this and then one back off. So we'll work up to the top set now.
Thank you.
So moving on to leg extension, just added a resistant band just to add more tension, because the load isn't heavy enough. So add a little blue band with a daisy chain. That's just going to provide more tension through the concentric and eccentric part of the movement. Adductor's done. The reason I like to do adductor first, or the reason I think doing adductor is good to do first, is it opens up the hips. I've noticed in the past that I've had tight hips going into legs, which isn't great. You can't get into the hole on your leg pressing movements, on your squatting movements. So putting adductor first or second in your session is a great idea. So we're going to go to leg extension, then into leg curl, which is also banded. So when going to the leg extension, what I like to do with the front pad is keep it midway up your shin, so opposite your calf, which is just going to give us more control throughout the movement. If you have it too near your feet, near your ankles, you're going to be less in control, and contraction is going to be harder to get. So keep it quite high up. It's going to feel weird the first time you do it, but trust me, it's going to give you more control throughout the movement and get the most out of the set. Has fucked me up big time. I think working in two sorts of rep ranges, you got the 6 to 8s, and then that was our backup, which was, you know, 25. So I think, you know, getting strong in every single rep range, especially with legs, so I think legs thrive off doing low volume and high volume in the same kind of session. Your legs are just going to blow up. So yeah, getting strong in every single rep range, I think, is, you know, a primary factor within training. Don't just stick to one, don't just do 6 to 8s for the whole session. Put in some 20s, put in some 25s, even go up to 30s. You know, really fatigue that muscle. Because essentially after your top set, after your heavy set, you're gonna be stronger on the, you will be stronger on the 25 to 30 rep range. So try and implement that when you can. So moving on to the leg curl, just adding the red band to, again, add more resistance. But yeah, this is third movement in before a hack squat and leg press. I talked about before, calories are slightly lower at the moment, just to put our body in a better body composition. But 6 meals a day on a training day, and 5 to 6 on a rest day. But yeah, food seems good. Energy seems good in the gym. Nothing really to complain about at the moment, with calories being this low, which since October is the lowest they've been. So, and we're getting stronger in the gym. You know, we're not stalling. We're still progressing on the lifts. So we couldn't really be in a better place at the moment. As I said before, we're going to do this for another week or two with calories low, and then see what Luke says. His plan to push again, or I'm not too sure. We're just going to see how the body reacts to these calories now, and then we'll kind of just go from there. Using my squatting shoes, the little platform one, always before this, for a good few months, and then I had a little niggle in my right shin at the start of this phase on the hack squat, and just swapped to wearing Converse, a flat shoe, and the difference is massive. I'm putting some knee sleeves on as well, because I was always like, if when he's hurt, I'll put knee sleeves on, but I think the comfort that it brings and the heat around the knee and all that. I had a niggle was in my patella tendon, so just going to a flat shoe and putting knee sleeves on has dramatically helped. Literally on the first two leg sessions that I did, I couldn't go heavy. Most I got up to was 3 plates aside, and it was painful. So by having knees, I can go decently heavy on both hack squat and leg press. To the top set on this. Last week I got finished just 4 plates. 4 plates aside for 6 to 8, I think. I'm gonna go up to, which felt really good. So I'm gonna go up to 4.5 plates. See how we do with that. 6 to 8. Aim for 6. Any more than 6 is a bonus.
Right, mate, let's go.
to 85 aside, more likely. Just to play it safe, really. Because we're still really just in the start of training, so. Slowly progressing. Last 6 reps was a push, so which was good. Now into, as I said, 25 reps, just to burn the quads out, which will be fun. to hyperextension, 45 degree, our second to last movement before calf raise. This is kind of like the call it the cool down after brutal squat and press, but two sets, two sets of eight, just with a dumbbell, focusing on more on the stretch, and keeping the back slightly rounded. You don't want to bring the lower back into it. So. Session yesterday. We had two movements in it where we missed out on one rep. It was incline Smith, which we missed out on one. And what was the one? The crucifix lateral raises. Main thing I think it was because of our rest day on Sunday. Just lower calories and going into the session. Because we train kind of fast, the only thing I have in the session if at the start of the day is 50 gram of carbs and amino acids. So I think the rest day played a bit of a part in that. So we'll see what happens next week on Monday. But it's just interesting. See how we can manage that going forward. Yesterday, it was a good session, but as I was saying before, there was a few reps that were missed. But the chest from push yesterday is hurting like hell. So, but yeah, had to show up and get the job done today. That is legs finished. Just finishing on the bike now. 5 minutes just to cool down because we don't want to be cramping up in the car on the way home. So that's the worst thing. I remember it happened to me a few times last year because I didn't cool down. I had to pull over and get out and stretch, which is not ideal, is it? So 5 minutes on it to take us home, just to think about the session and how it went, but overall, we hit all numbers that I wanted to hit. Intensity was very high. Just loving this plan, loving this these leg sessions that Luke's put in the plan for me. So rest day tomorrow, which I'm honestly looking forward to. After two training sessions back to back, I'm pretty much ready for a rest day. So yeah, high calories today, that's training day, and then low calories tomorrow is a rest day. So but yeah, no, good. Good session. I'm just thinking back on the session, really. I'm still in a bit of a blur, so yeah, rest day tomorrow, then pull on Thursday. We're gonna be filming football. Jack. We're gonna be filming football, yeah. Yeah, we are, so we've got yeah, so pull Thursday and then push Friday. I think we're filming for that as well. So yeah, all in all, good session. I'm going to leave it there, really. We're going to go home after this post-workout meal. And then morning cardio, because it's only 8 o'clock, bang on time. So, yeah, we're going to leave it there. Thank you for watching. If you've watched this far, if you've managed to get through the session, hopefully these videos give you some information, some knowledge. I'm not the most scientific guy when it comes to training. I like to just share what I'm doing and share through experience, really. Hopefully give you some motivation to take it to your sessions, and a few pointers that you can add into your movements to make them better. But yeah, thank you for watching, and we'll see you on the next video.